Sanibonani, Thobela, dear staff and students. As many of you would know, Saturday marks exactly 25 years since the dawn of multi-party democracy in our beloved country. As we commemorate Freedom Day tomorrow, on the 27th of April 2019, we should also reflect on the milestones that have been achieved in transforming our country into a society we aspire it to be. Ours is a relatively young democracy, and the challenges remain that many of our people still live in squalor, while poverty, joblessness, and inequality continue to blight our hard-earned freedom is apparent to all. Similarly, a lot has been achieved on many fronts. Notably, many of our students from disadvantaged backgrounds are today able to access higher education freely, spared the pain and agony of being excluded for financial reasons. This is born out of the realization that making education accessible to qualifying and capable students is an investment which can yield great returns economically, culturally, socially, and even politically. I cannot begin to emphasize, therefore, how important it is to embrace this freedom with responsibility. In this context, it is quite unfortunate to see some of our students intentionally resorting to provocative or disruptive behavior with scant regard or care for others. As our liberation icon Nelson Mandela once said, and I quote, "It is so easy to break down and destroy. Heroes are those who make peace and build," close quote. Or even better, Madiba said, and I quote, "I cherish my own freedom dearly, but I care even more for your freedom," close quote. As we return to our campuses on Tuesday after the Easter long weekend, you would have noticed that our campus TV network screens have now gone live as communicated recently. The campus TV network project will complement the existing UJ communication platforms, supplementing digital content that is relevant for our staff and students. The screens are positioned in strategic public locations, broadcasting public lectures and book launch invitations, student and staff activities, as well as local and international news, among others. Please do not hesitate to contact content managers to share content from your domains. This service is there to aid your communication with the university community. Speaking of campus TV screens and events, we are now in the final stages of our autumn graduation ceremonies. I am delighted to call global civil society activist Dr. Kumi Naidoo one of our own. As shared with you last week, he became the latest high-profile person our university conferred with an honorary doctorate on Tuesday, 23 April 2019. Equally, we also welcome Professor Romain Murenzi, the current Executive Director of the World Academy of Sciences, to our UJ family. It was gratifying to listen to both of them sharing their insightful views about South Africa and the world today. Professor Murenzi had, on Tuesday, 23 April 2019, delivered a keynote address entitled "Advancing Science in the Global South, the Role of the World Academy of Sciences." His lecture at our Johannesburg Institute of Advanced Study was indeed inspirational, and we couldn't have asked for more from someone of Professor Murenzi's stature. Professor Murenzi and Dr. Naidoo, congratulations. We are proud to call you distinguished UJ alumni. Annually, fellow colleagues gather to celebrate being part of the diverse UJ family. This year, on Friday, the 24th May 2019, we will have our annual staff day at the University of Johannesburg West Sports Fields with lots of entertainment activities. This day was introduced to UJ many years ago to promote cultural integration by allowing all UJ staff to interact with one another on an equal footing. The theme for this year's event is "Our Blood is Orange," in keeping with our brand colors. Our staff day also reminds us of the 14 years of UJ's collective excellence. Let us register in large numbers and show our appreciation and support for our values in May. Leading up to May 24th, The university's transformation unit will keep you up to date with the necessary information. I look forward to seeing you there. On a sad note, it is heartbreaking to learn of the passing away of one of our students, Miss Sinegugu Peaceful Nonkululeko Zikalala. She was a third-year student studying Bachelor of Engineering Technology in Industrial Engineering. Sinegugu was also a House Committee Treasurer at Pumlani Residence at the Doornfontein campus. To the Zikalala family, friends and colleagues of Sinegugu, we hope you find strength and solace in each other's love, in the memories of your loved one throughout this difficult time. On behalf of the university community, please accept our heartfelt condolences. I thank you all and have a good weekend.